Yuchengco Group-led Mapua University is one of the Philippines' leading IT schools and its subsidiaries, Malayan Colleges Laguna and Malayan Colleges Mindanao. With us now for more is Dr. Reynaldo Vea, President and CEO of Mapua University. He is also the President of iPeople, which has the University of Nueva Caceres, Natural Teachers College, and the Apex Schools as subsidiaries. Good to see you, Dr. Vea. Welcome to the program.
Hi, Kathy. Good morning.
Good morning. So how should we restart education following a lockdown? I mean, there's been conflicting statements of late, and schools are needing more clarity.
Well, first of all, I think there should be a greater role for online education. And the students must be given a choice to engage in this mode. But since there will be students returning to class, presumably in August, there should also be a role for what is known as blended learning, where we blend our face-to-face with online elements so that we'll be able to satisfy the requirements of physical distancing. So, you know, a portion of the students could be online and only a portion could be in school at any given time. So the classroom, which usually fits 40 students, can be made to fit half of that or less than half of that.
These are pictures pre-pandemic. I mean, we probably won't see it for a period when we get to see more than 15 students at a time in a classroom. A lot's been said about what you just said, online learning and blended learning, but is the country ready for either of that, infrastructure-wise and culture-wise?
Well, I guess I have to say that there'll be a lot to be desired in terms of connectivity, that the bandwidth must be made more affordable and must be made, at a greater range so that the greater bandwidth can satisfy the requirements of online learning. So there should be improvements along that score. On the side of the universities, I think there are learning management systems that are widely available, but not all of them are really affordable. But if you go with the open source learning management system, then schools could participate in this mode of delivery. But then the faculty members will also have to be trained in online learning because it is something new. That will be something new to them.
Right. Have you done a survey or asked the faculty what they think about online learning and the students as well?
Well, in our case, I can only speak, I guess, for Mapua. We did try fully online learning in March upon the proclamation of ECQ. And we have finished the term. We have finished our third quarter, and we found that overwhelming majority of them were able to engage, and only a very small majority were not able to engage at all. We don't want to refer to it as a statistic because the students who were not able to engage will be given a chance in the next quarter to catch up using a blended learning approach.
Why hadn't they been available or been able to take part in this effort?
Yes, and I'm basing that based on the grades that they got in their courses. And the majority of them actually were able to pass. And that means that they were able to fulfill the requirements under a fully online setup.
Right. And that would be... Which brings us to the issue of how do you ensure that no student is left behind in this digitalization effort, keeping online or blended learning from disenfranchising those without an internet connection or those who could not afford to pay for one?
Well, we just have to, like in our case, those who are not able to participate will be given a chance to catch up in the next quarter. But if we did not do this, we would have, on the other hand, or a majority of our students, on the other hand, would have lost the opportunity to advance in their program of study. And that is the overwhelming majority of our students.
And I see that your enrollment in your schools are now ongoing. I've checked out your website. How is Mapua University and all the subsidiaries planning for when the lockdown restrictions change? If we do see looser restrictions from Monday, what is Mapua prepared to do under this new normal of physically distance learning?
Well, for Monday, I think classes will still be suspended and we'll still have to go fully online. But in August, we will offer the choice of a fully online program for those who are still fearful of face-to-face. But for those who are willing to come in and go to class, what we'll offer is a blended learning approach where we're going to flip the class so that they can prepare for class part of the week, and they come to class maybe once or twice a week in order to engage in discussions, clarify questions they may have, and also interact with their fellow students. So we'll both have in August a fully online and a blended learning flipped classroom approach. But for June, we'll still have to be fully online.
Will this shift to a new normal cost a lot? I mean, what is its impact on your OPEX, for instance, as a share of your total expenditures for the school year?
Well, in terms of expenses, we have faculty members with their loading, and most of the expenses would still be on tuition, where we have to pay the faculty members for online education. But probably we'll see a little savings on utilities and also on laboratory expenses, for which we offer discounts to students and a share of our savings.
It's going to be interesting to see how that all pans out when you do the flip by August. On a broader scale, and I mean, Mapua's got itself sorted out on what it plans to do in the new normal, but what would you recommend or propose to the government and other academic institutions as to the kind of direction the whole education sector needs to get to the new normal?
Well, there's an option to go flexible learning, which means that they don't have to be digital all the time. So the materials may be, physical in nature, and the delivery need not necessarily be online. And then they can have a mixed mode of delivery, mixed mode of media content, and so on. And that will be more feasible for many schools, I think. And our National Teachers College is actually an advocate of that type of flexible learning. For government, I really do hope that the problem of bandwidth could be solved. We're talking with the telcos to make packages that are affordable to our students. But beyond that, we really need more bandwidth. But I guess that is for the farther future. For Chad, I think we're very happy that the Commission on Higher Education has taken a very open-minded approach to online learning and to flexible learning. So they're not just allowing schools to do it, but in fact they are supporting schools that would want to go into it. In fact, Mapua has been invited to give a webinar, to the presidents of state universities and colleges to share our experience. And we've made a proposal that we can train the faculty of other schools as well.
Right, it's good that you're taking initiative early on. You do let us know on how the grades look like at the end of the quarter. That'd be really interesting to see how successful your initiatives had been. Dr. Ray, thank you so much and keep well.
Well, my pleasure, Kathy.
Reynaldo Vea of Mapua University.